So, I mean, this is a big NFC South battle from this game. What is your main takeaway here? Obviously, Trevor Siemian, you know, you had hoped that he could get the job done for the Saints. They were in this one right to the very end. But, I mean, what are you taking away from this if you're the Saints?
They might want to make a call to Philip Rivers. Siemian did some good things late in the game to get him back into it. There was a questionable pass interference penalty as well. But they're in trouble without their quarterback. And people will say, well, Jameis Winston's not that good. He is good. He's better than this guy for a reason, and that's why he should be in the game. And the fact that he's hurt really is a damning blow maybe to the Saints. As good as their defense is, look, Matt Ryan carved them up today. 2 for 343. And this is a team that's undermanned on the offensive side of the ball. No Ridley. So I think this is a bad loss for the Saints.
I wonder how much, and I'm sure the Falcons are going to look back at that game last week against the Panthers, because we know the Panthers aren't very good. Bad loss for them. The Ridley news, remember, he was a surprise inactive before the game. I wonder when they got the news and how shell-shocked the team might have been, because they just were not in sync offensively. They look much better today. They got to do a better job running the ball, obviously. 25 carries, 34 yards. Did get the touchdown from Matt Ryan sneaking one in, but obviously the running backs as a whole. But Matt Ryan really stepping up in this game, and he's going to be the reason if they do make the playoffs. Right now they're, you know, teetering in terms of being a wild card team. But back to 500 after the slow start, and him going for 343 and 2, and just making something out of Cordarrelle Patterson, that's obviously on the coaching staff as well. Kyle Pitts had another strong day, 3 for 62. Russell Gage stepping up, 7 for 64. So they're going to make things sort of get by until we get Calvin Ridley back, and hopefully we do. But I think I got to give credit to this Falcons defense. They played really well in holding down the Saints offense. I know they're limited offensively also, but strong performance from Atlanta all the way around.
And Matt Ryan's had a really good season, quietly.
Quietly.
Because he hasn't had his guys together at all, and he's still putting up good numbers and playing good, sound football, and he doesn't get the credit for that.
And Saints are only a game back in that division. I mean, Tampa Bay's got 6 wins. They're in at 5. So, I mean, we talk about the fact that their quarterback play and the fact they've been missing, but, I mean, they've been able to put it together so far.
But this is what you, the classic letdown game.
Yeah, it happens all the time.
Beat up the Bucks last week.
Yeah, it happens in this league all the time. A team puts so much into beating a good team, they beat them, and then they kind of go flat the next week.
Jamie, what about Olamide Zaccheaus? Were you surprised at what you saw from him today?
Not really. I mean, you know, somebody's always going to have these type of games. Last week was Tajay Sharpe stepping up. The guy for me that I really would look at more is Russell Gage, because he had 8 targets, 7 for 64. You know, he's the one that we said coming into the season, no Julio Jones. Can he step up and help fill that void? And he hasn't done it. Injuries have been a problem for him. Patterson stepping up has obviously been a big part of this offense. But now with Ridley not there, you know it's going to be two games now after this matchup. If he's going to continue to get anywhere north of 7 targets per week, he should be on your radar, and he's going to be talked about next week for sure.
All right, they're going to be talking about that on Fantasy Football Today, of course, a podcast format. And, of course, you can see it every day at noon Eastern time here on HQ. But the podcast, Jamie and company do a great job on the podcast, giving you daily drops of everything you need to know in terms of setting your lineup, who to pick up. Fantasy Football Today, the podcast. Download and follow wherever you get your podcast audio.
Do you want a sports network that delivers everything that matters about the game? The highlights, the picks, the instant analysis. No yelling, no fake debates, no politics. Hit the subscribe button and never miss a moment.